since October 17 of 2019, mass demonstrations have rocked not just the capital, Beirut, as we're accustomed to, but there have been protests nationwide. As a matter of fact, in the first 2 weeks of the demonstrations, almost 400 towns and villages in a country that's really small have engaged in some kind of either direct action or mobilization. So what's going on right now in Lebanon and has been ongoing for the past 3 months marks a rupture with the past, a definitive resounding no to the politics of the civil war, the politics around the sectarian system that's been entrenched for the past 30 years or so. So right now, the population in Lebanon has a real opportunity to regain the power that has been stolen from it for decades. And this is why what's happening is so significant and could mark a turning point in the country's history. The reactions have kind of been all over the place. They varied from many attempts of co-optation. The main party that's represented by the Lebanese president, the Free Patriotic Movement, has tried at first to portray these demonstrations as an extension of the struggle that it had waged in the 90s. There are other political parties that have tried to distance themselves from the mobilization, saying that they're all thugs, that they're not representative of really the population and what their demands and aspirations are. There have been attempts at portraying it as some kind of foreign infiltration. So the response, because the ruling class in Lebanon is not homogenous, as opposed to other places where you have one dictator, and because there are so many different political parties that are represented in government, the responses have varied widely. There's absolutely a lot of space to exploit these differences between the political parties. Unfortunately, they have been one step ahead of us. So, for example, the Lebanese forces who resigned early on in the demonstrations and later asked their supporters to join protesters on the ground have been trying to act as the de facto leaders of this mobilization. Even though early on in the demonstrations, people were very aware of these types of tactics, and as soon as Lebanese forces supporters came to the ground or one of their leaders, they were immediately expelled from the public squares. But now it's becoming more and more difficult as a variety of different political parties are asking their supporters to join. So unfortunately, protesters have not been able to exploit these differences and the bickering that's ongoing between the parties as a response to this demonstration. The first 2 to 3 weeks, there was this kind of euphoria and this belief that the Lebanese population is shedding these political, religious affiliations, not affiliations, but identifications, that people are rallying much more around class than sectarian affiliations. And that has happened to a large extent. And there is a significant segment of the people who are demonstrating on the streets who want to shed these types of affiliations and the type of relationships of patronage that they have been accustomed to. We can only hope that this segment of population continues to grow. But this euphoria that we felt at first, that this would really be the end of the sectarian political system, has not really materialized in a manner that we had aspired to.